Hi guys, this is Shivati. Welcome to microservices tutorial. In this session, I am going to explain introduction to microservices. Before we go in detail about the microservices, let us see what are the advantages and disadvantages of the monolithic application. Now let us consider we have a banking monolithic application. So monolithic application is an application where you will have the complete set of your application will be in one server. Now, for example, if you see here, if it is a banking application, we have the browser client UI, which basically interact with the server side. Server is having a complete bunch of services as a one package. Now, if you see here, banking can have a user services, account services, and transaction services. And these services basically talk to the database. Now, these three modules together, it is going to be packed as a single application, which is where we are going to deploy into the server. That is called as a monolithic application. Now, let us see the advantages of the monolithic application. So, the first advantage is, it is very simple to develop and the test and deploy, because we are basically considering the only one environment all together as a one environment. So it is easy to develop, test and deployment. And let us consider if you have a requirement where number of the users are using for your application is going to be increased, then what you are going to do is you are going to do the horizontal scaling. That means you will have the you are going to add few more instances of your application, and each instance have the same set of the configuration or the database and the server. So let us consider you are going to add the 5 instances, and you will consider a one load balancer, and the load balancer is basically distribute your users load to these instances. So horizontal scaling is going to be happen. And the next one is maintenance is easy, because here we are not using any complex maintenance process, because it is a single instance. And if you want to add more instances, you have to create a separate instance. We have to just add, and that needs to be pointing to the load balancer. But there are certain drawbacks with this monolithic application. As the first point is the productivity of the developers. Now let us consider if a new person coming to your application and then he want to develop a new feature, then he has to understand all the dependent modules for your application and the architecture. That means it is going to take time for a new developer to who basically onboarded currently for your project. In order to start development, it is going to take the more time, as he has to understand the underlying dependent component. And second one is, as this is the monolithic application, is a single application where your code completely resides. So in order to build your project, and also when you load it into the Eclipse, the performance of the Eclipse is going to be decreased because of the huge size of your project. And then once you develop the application, if you want to test it on the server, server startup time is also going to take time, because it has to prepare all the dependent modules, modules, objects, and it has to start your application. So this is from the productive perspective. And second one is, whenever you develop any monolithic application, the technology constraint on adapting the new technologies. For example, if you are developing in one application based on the Java, and tomorrow if there is any new trending technology comes with the which basically develop the same feature with the faster development, then monolithic application is very difficult to adapting to the new technology. And the next one is more resources utilization due to the horizontal scaling. Let us consider in this monolithic application, I want there are more users basically accessing the transaction services. In that case, in the monolithic application, you cannot basically provide or allocate the resources for the particular component. If you want to add the resources, you have to add for the complete resources as a one another instance. But you cannot prioritize the resources for the particular service, and you have to provide a you cannot provide the resource allocation for the less for the another services. That is the another pain point when we are working with the monolithic application. And also, application is too large and complex to fully understand and make changes fast and correctly. So as your application is big and you have to understand complete dependent modules, then only you can go and make the changes. So that is the reason it is not easy. You can directly do the on-fly, or you cannot do basically any change on fly or quickly, because you have to consider all the dependent use cases and reliability and fault tolerance. Now let us suppose there is some bug issue with the user services code. Then if you have any memory leaks kind of a thing, or the connection is not getting closed, then what happens is this service can bring down complete application server down. Because here you cannot have any one service. If it goes down, then automatically the server will be going down. That means there is a tight coupling between the services or the services available in the monolithic application. So that is the reason reliability and fault tolerance is going to be very does not have the reliability and fault tolerance, because single bug in the application, it automatically bring down the all your complete server down. And then isolation of the deployment is not possible. That means let us consider I am working on some feature on the user services. Now I want to deploy this particular piece of code. Then in the case of monolithic application, you have to bring the complete server down, then only you can deploy your changes. And the next one is monolithic application can also be difficult to scale when different modules having the conflict resource requirement. As I explained, let us consider you have the account services is basically used by the some of the users more. Then if you want to add some resources for the exclusive to the account services, it is not possible. Either you have to increase the instances or you have to decrease the instances. This is the only possibility in the monolithic applications. And the finally, the continuous deployment is difficult because you are not the continuous deployment is difficult because of your complexity of your program, and also the continuous deployment means it ideally requires the outage for your application, because in the monolithic application, if you want to bring down one system, then you have to bring down the complete application. So that is the reason if you want to do continuous deployment, then ideally your application, your servers has to bring down. That means there is a business outage will be there. So these are the pain points basically with the monolithic applications. Now that is the reason nowadays most of the projects, whatever it is developing, they are going with the microservices architecture. Now let us see how we are going to design the same monolithic application in the microservices architecture. Now here in the microservices architecture, basically your complex business application requirement will be divided into a smaller components, which can independently test and independently deploy. So that is the paradigm we basically consider in the microservices architecture. And when we are designing the microservice architecture, we need to keep in mind that we need to separate the components or the services in such a way that there is a no or minimum minimum dependence between the services, so that we are going to develop independently, test independently, and deploy independently. Okay, so now let us see what are the advantages of the microservices architecture. So the first one is divide the application into a set of manageable services, which are much faster to develop and easier to understand and maintain. Second one is most suitable for the agility. That means, as we know, agility in the sense there is a frequent change in the business requirement perspective, and also easy to change, because if there is any change comes, then you have to easy to change. That means easy to develop, easy to test, and easy to maintain. So that is the reason the microservices architecture is most suitable for the agile methodology. And the next point is, the when it comes to the productivity of the developer is going to be high, because the team can basically focus on focus and develop independently of the services without much knowledge, without much deep into the details of the dependent components. And the productivity for the developers is improved, as the scope is limited and freedom to work on the new technology stack. Now here in the microservices architecture, the agenda of this one is how fast you can develop and independently develop and deploy, and then you can use it to maintain. And the next step, the next point here is that as everyone, every business requirement is basically divided into a small microservice, they can independently develop, test, and deploy. And let us consider, today we are using the one technology, and tomorrow there is a new technology which comes in the industry, which basically help the developers to develop microservices faster. Then the microservices architecture provide a freedom to go and adapt the new technology as well. And then scaling the resources on demand for the specific services is possible, because now when we talk about a overall application, let us consider we have the user services, account services, and transaction services. All these together as a all together basically providing the bank microservices architecture as a one application. Now here, let us consider whenever account services has a more demand or the more feature which is used by the customers, then now we can provide the more resources only for this account services, and we can keep the resources minimum for the user services and the transaction services. And another important point here is the isolation and the fault tolerance. Now let us consider, in your application account services went down, then still the user services and transaction services are available for the end users, because whatever the services we are developing using microservices architecture are independently are mostly is going to be independently work each other. There is a no or very minimum dependency will be there between the microservices. Now that is the reason isolation and fault tolerance can be achieved in isolation and the fault tolerance can be can mitigate our overall functionality of the application. What we are going to do here is, we basically, one services go down, then still user can able to access the other services. So that is the isolation and the fault tolerance. Now these are the some of the advantages of while basically talking about the microservices architecture. Now let us see what are the drawbacks. Now when you moving the when you want to plan the microservices, it is not a simple change. It basically requires the cultural change in the organization, because you have to taken care of few of the organizational cultural change, like you have to adapt it to the DevOps, and you have to adapt it to the Agile methodology, and you have to adapt it to the DevOps new technologies. And the second drawback is intercommunication between the services can be slow, as each service is deployed in the another remote server. Now let us consider, in the case of monolithic application, all the services are will be in the same server. So that is the reason interaction between these components is very easy. But when it comes to the microservices, this service, user services might be in one server, account services will be in the another server, and transaction server services will be in the another server. So in order to communicate between these services, there is a small delay will be there. And also, In order to deploy the microservices is more complex and requires expertise on the DevOps tools like a Docker, Kubernetes, Chef, Ansible, Puppet, and service discovery tools like a etcd console and Apache Zookeeper. These are the technology you must be strong in order to use the microservices. And also another disadvantage with the microservice architecture is it will be little bit difficult to basically to debug the any issue difficult to debug the issue because in case of single monolithic application we have the log files are will be in the only one server. You can go and access the log files and you can easily troubleshoot the issue. But in the case of microservices architecture, there is a different set of instances will be there. And let us consider if you have replicating the each service in the multiple containers or the multiple nodes, then again you have to get the all the logs from the all the instance level logs, and then you have to verify the issue. So that is the reason it is little bit difficult to debug and a little bit difficult to maintain also. That means maintenance we can say, but basically it is the part from that means the complexity is going to be shifted from the developers to the basically the from the DevOps admin team, where in order to troubleshoot the issue it is going to take more time. So this is basically the introduction to what is the monolithic application, what are the microservices architecture, and how we are going to benefit out of the microservices architecture. Thanks for watching.